coming up against your Whisper. Oh, I just got her number. Ball jammers on the line, right on the stand.
These kids got no bets.
Sharpie markers over. Keep rolling right here. And it's a big hit. Giving ample opportunity for a racer to get up, get out of the back, and give him a little jam. After taking a wide outside attempt to get out of it, kill shot. Comes out of nowhere on the scene. Sniper target kill shot and takes her out. Great shot by kill shot. She makes a solid jammer coming around the outside. Got up there and just knocked her out as hard as she could. Meanwhile, racer, 5-point grand slam for the black team. Hands to the hips, hoping to maybe sneak one out before it gets held off, but no points either side, 0-0 champion. And it will remain 82-32 with about 5 minutes left in this second period. Shelby Camaro coming out to take her toe stops on the concrete up against Bittersweet Tiffany for the Lightning. Jammer's gonna go face to face, skate to skate, against each other for a two-minute jam or less. Looks like 3-on-3 is the back strength as far as blockers go, but now puts the jam into a 3-on-4 in favor of the green team, and the green team gains the blocker back. Oh, what a good blocker to get back out of the penalty box.
Allie always with a massive hit right there. Another strong hit to the inside.
Poison Ivory. Meanwhile, up front, Shelby Camaro trying to find a way past two blockers on the last time in defense. They gotta let her go. It's a complete shatter goes to the green team. A9 and Paris are doing one heck of a job up front. Julian Lillian with the jammer, keeping that bay for as long as they could.
Another good hit right there for Allie Always, knocking. Bittersweet Tiffany ends up forcing a minor cut. And it looks like a major penalty going to the green team jammer.
Last line of defense on that front.
That's right, they cannot do that. They go sit there at the box. Allie Always is all over Bittersweet Tiffany, keeping her locked up way behind the back.
Skaters have to stay within 20 feet of the back to be in the engagement zone, otherwise they cannot engage. Well, they can engage, but the ref sees it. Full packs on the track right now. As we get ready to rock, just under 2 minutes left, we could have 152 games left in this period. 50 points still in their first right now. Black team needs to get it going. Both teams up through full force and just as I said, black team. Alex now at 2-on-4 as far as pack strength goes. In the back, the main dissatisfaction of Dave Bosch taking a seat in the penalty box.
Whiskey stopper putting the hurt and on the black camera is another strike cast for Vicious Velma. And she is a grand slam machine tonight. Spanky behind, hit the switch taken to her by Whiskey Sour.
Only scores points by 5.
And guess what? Here she goes again. Another grand slam for Vicious Velma, racking them up right now for the dream team.
Three scored 15 points already?
Indeed it is.
I don't know, three?
Vicious Velma gets some help around the outside. Another great job by the great blockers to dominate. 5 more points, 20 point jam, and she's still got time to go. We'll see if she can get another scoring pass in with about 5 seconds left. Back trying to keep it in front of her. The black back shooting sped up, and that lands it. But already 20 point jam. And the green team gets the second mark, 102-32. Huge jam for number 5, 7, 7, 8.
20 points in a single jam, quadruple grand slam for Vicious Velma.
And then let me second period. Another quick break. We're going to let these teams get a breather, talk some more strategy, put some time up on the clock, and let the officials make sure everything's in order for the last 20 minute stanza of the Bass City Roller Girls and Friends Roller Derby Jam Stravaganza here at the Walter Trade Center.
I heard from this afternoon entertainment the referees have a puppet show.